哈利路亚，各位弟兄姐妹，大家安息日平安。
Hallelujah to all the brothers and sisters. Happy Sabbath day.
感谢主，在这个神所赐福的日子，使我们能够一同聚集在他的圣堂。
We thank God for gathering us today on His holy Sabbath day, His blessed day in His holy temple.
也愿主的恩惠、平安，并圣灵中的喜乐，能够时常与我们同在。
May His grace, peace, and the joy of the Spirit be continually be with us.
在过去的这个星期，我们在尔湾教会举行高中生的学生灵恩会。
Throughout this past week, we have been holding the J2 student spiritual convocation here in Irvine Church.
每一次当教会在办活动。
Every time we have seminars in the church,
总是不能够忘记感谢地方教会的帮助以及付出。
We always cannot forget to give thanks for the sacrifice and the love of the local brothers and sisters in the church.
因为有弟兄姐妹的爱心，
because of the love of the brothers and sisters,
才有训练活动的机会。
Then we can have the opportunity to hold these seminars.
所以在这里要特别感谢尔湾教会。
So here I'd like on behalf of the students to give thanks to the Irvine Church.
不但能够提供给我们一个很适合的场所。
You have provided us with a very suitable facility.
同时很多弟兄姐妹在这当中不断的为我们给我们提供很多的帮助。
And at the same time, many brothers and sisters have been providing us with a lot of help.
愿主耶稣纪念大家的爱心跟辛劳。
May the Lord Jesus Himself remember your labor and love.
教会要办活动。
When the church is holding an activity,
是因为看到训练工作的重要。
It is because we see the need of some training.
教会当中的年轻人，
the youth in the church,
代表的是教会将来的发展跟兴旺，
represents the prosperity and the progress of the future.
如果有好的青年，
if we have good youth,
在将来自然会有好的工人，
in the future, we will naturally have good workers.
而当教会当中有好的工人，
when the church has good workers,
自然借着神的帮助就能够使教会福音得以兴旺。
Naturally, through the help of God, we can progress the evangelism of the church.
所以今天早上的聚会当中，
through this morning's worship service,
我们想要用在侍奉当中的学习榜样做我们大家学习的内容。
We want to use some examples of servitude from the Bible for our content.
我们请翻到以西结书的第四十四章。
Let us refer to the book of Ezekiel, chapter 44.
以西结书的四十四章。
The book of Ezekiel, chapter 44.
第十五节
Verse 15
以西结书的第四十四章的第十五节
Ezekiel chapter 44 verse 15
以色列人走迷离开我的时候祭司利未人撒都的子孙仍看守我的圣所他们必亲近我侍奉我并且侍立在我面前将脂油与血献给我这是主神说的十六节
16.
他们必进入我的圣所就近我的桌前侍奉我守我所吩咐的在这里呢神告诉以色列百姓
Here the Lord instructed the Israelites
他说有一群利未人在神的眼中是不一样的
There's a group of Levites that is different among the people
他们虽然都是利未人虽然都是祭司
Even though they were all priests and Levites
但是在这里说撒都的子孙在神眼中非常的不同
But here the sons of Zadok in the eyes of God they were very different
甚至神特别把他们的名字拿出来
God especially mentioned about their names.
并且神在这里特别的强调。
And over here he emphasized.
说这些祭司要来到我的面前。
These priests shall come near to me.
他们必要亲近我必要侍奉我。
They will come near to me to minister to me.
我们会觉得很奇怪啊。
We feel it very strange.
祭司本来就是在侍奉神的。
The duty of a priest is actually to minister to God.
所以利未人祭司本来就侍奉在神的面前。
Naturally, the Levites and the priests, their duties are to minister to God.
但是为什么在这里神要特别把撒都的子孙拿出来讲？
But why is it that over here God picked out the sons of Zadok?
而且不但拿出来说，还特别为他们的侍奉 定下一个标准。
Not only did he pick them out, but he also set a standard for their servitude.
说他们要亲近我。
Saying they shall come near to me.
他们要侍奉我。
They shall minister to me.
啊，他们要站在我的面前。
They shall stand before me.
我们会觉得说，这本来不就是一个祭司的责任吗
？When we think about it, aren't these all the basic duties of a priest?
啊，但是我们如果再回头来看呢、啊、
？But when we come to look at it,
以西结书的四十四章。
Ezekiel chapter 44,
第十节
verse 10.
这里说，当以色列人走迷的时候，有利未人远离我，就是走迷离开我，随从他们的偶像，他们必担当自己的罪孽。十一节
verse 11.
然而他们必在我的圣地中当仆役，照管殿门，在殿中供职，宰杀牲畜和平安祭，站在民。站在民前侍候他们。第十二节
Verse 12.
十二节，因为这些利未人曾在偶像前侍候这名，成了以色列家罪孽的绊脚石，所以我向他们起誓，他们必担当自己的罪孽。这是神说的。十三节
Verse 13.
他们不可亲近我。所以我们在这里如果做一个比较，
So here when we make a comparison,
都是利未人，
They're all Levites,
都是祭司，
They're all priests,
但是在神的眼中却是两种完全不一样的人。
But in the eyes of God, they were two completely different people.
我们如果仔细看，他们都在服事。
When we pay great attention, they're all in servitude.
但是他们两种人，他的服事的价值是完全不同的。
The values of their servitude, however, differ from one another.
对这些走迷的利未人来说，
To all these Israelites who went astray,
利未人哈。
The Levites.
神说他们不可亲近我。
God said they shall never come near me.
你可以做事情。
You can do your things.
你可以参与工作。
You can participate in holy work.
但是神说你不能亲近我。
But you cannot come near me.
也不能接近圣物。
You cannot also come near the holy items.
甚至在这里，圣经特别告诉我们。
Even here, the Bible tells us.
他说他们是侍立在这些百姓的面前。
They can only minister before the people.
我们如果做一个对比啊。
When we make a comparison.
利未人不可以亲近神。
The Levites cannot come before God.
但是撒都的子孙必要亲近我。
But the sons of Zadok, however, shall come near me.
这些利未人是站在百姓的面前。
These Levites were only allowed to stand before the people.
但是撒都的子孙却是站立侍候在神的面前。
But the sons of Zadok can come near and minister to God.
所以在这里要给你我今天在参与圣工的人一个观念。
This gives us a value system for you and me who are in servitude.
一个人有在参与圣工，不代表他侍立在神的面前。
A person who participates in holy work, it does not mean that he is set up in front of God.
有在做圣工，不代表你有在亲近神。
When you are doing sacred work, it does not mean that you are drawing near to God.
很多时候我们如果不小心，
Many a times without careful attention,
我们到最后把所有的注意力都放在侍奉的工作上面。
As a result, we pay our attention to the work of in the sacred work.
好像做了很多。
It looks like we've done a lot.
好像跟神关系很好。
It looks like we're very intimate with God.
好像在教会当中很重要。
As if we are very important in the church.
但是我们如果没有仔细的去反省自我的内心世界。
But if we fail to examine once and again in our whole world inside of us.
请问你是侍立在谁的面前？
Let me ask you, who are you set up to face?
你是为了做圣工而做圣工？
Are you serving God because of the holy work?
还是因为你侍立在神面前，你有了这样的负担？
Or are you established before God, therefore you partake in this duty?
而且在这里特别告诉我们啊。
And here it especially tells us.
先有亲近神。
First, you have to come near to God.
后面才有侍奉神。
Then we can minister to God.
而这样的侍奉才能在神的面前啊。
And only can such ministry be before God.
它是有相连性的。
These are all related.
它是有 priority, 它是有先后顺序。
It comes with priority, which one comes first and which one comes last.
因为你亲近神。
Because you come near to God.
所以你的侍奉态度跟侍奉动机跟态度是正确的。
Therefore, the attitude and the motive of your servitude is correct.
亲近神，所以你爱神。
Because you come near to God, because you love God.
因为你爱神，所以你愿意侍奉。
Because you love God, you're willing to come to serve Him.
因为你侍奉，所以你用了全心。
Because you serve God, you use your whole heart.
到最后，你的侍奉能够站立在神的面前。
In the end, your servitude can come before God.
这是我们今天对教会每一个工人的期望。
This is our expectation and hope to all workers in the church.
每一位弟兄姐妹都必须要参与圣工。
Every brother and sister shall participate in holy work.
每一个工人都要有正确的侍奉态度。
Every worker shall have the correct attitude in servitude.
每一个人都要努力来亲近神。
Every one of us have to pay a lot of effort to come near to God.
但是怎么样才叫做亲近神呢？
But what is the meaning of drawing near to God?
什么样的工人才有资格侍立在神的面前？
Which type of worker can stand before God?
我们今天就从撒都的子孙身上来做一个学习。
Today we shall learn from the sons of Zadok.
我们看第十五节。
Let us read verse 15.
以西结书的第四十四章第十五节。
Ezekiel chapter 44, verse 15.
啊，这里说以色列人走迷离开我的时候，祭司利未人撒都的子孙仍看守我的圣殿。在这里谈到第一件事。
Here it refers to one happening.
他说以色列人离开神了。
The Israelites went astray from God.
啊，在这一段的历史当中。
In the history of this book.
啊，以色列人去拜偶像。
The Israelites, they worshipped idols.
以色列人离弃了神的殿。
The Israelites went away from the temple of God.
因为他们的系统啊，他们的组织的系统不太一样啊。
Because their hierarchy and their system is different.
他们的利未人本身是没有什么产业的。
The Levites, they themselves do not possess anything.
按照他们的整个国家的安排。
According to the arrangements made by the nation.
以色列人要把自己的粮食献到神的殿中。
The Israelites have to sacrifice their
offer, huh?
Offer up their first fruits to the temple.
带他们的对带带着他们的所收成的，要拿一些来到神的殿中。
Part of their harvest shall be offered to the sanctuary.
而利未人就是靠着这一些以色列人的奉献来维持他们的生活。
And the Levites shall live off of these offerings made by the Israelites.
这个是神为他们所设立的系统。
This is the system set by God for them.
就是以色列人献祭归给神。
Which means the Israelites offer to God.
神将这些资源分配给利未人。
And God will distribute these resources to the Levites.
使得利未人能够专心的来服侍神，来带领百姓。
So that the Levites can pay wholeheartedly attention to serving God and serving the people.
但是现在出了一个问题。
However, there's a problem here.
在这个环节当中少了一部分。
In this whole cycle, there's one thing lacking.
就是以色列人离开神了。
There's the Israelites, they left God.
离开神，离开信仰。
They left God and they left the faith.
自然而然就没有人再继续奉献了。
Naturally, there is a lack of offering to God.
因为没有人再奉献。
Because there's a lacking in offering.
代表利未人的生活所需没有人提供了。
This means that the Levites are lacking in their daily resources.
因为生活当中生活的需要没有了着落。
Because the Levites are lacking in their daily necessities.
所以自然的结果就是有些利未人就离开了。
So the natural outcome would be that some Levites have also departed.
他们需要找一些方法使他们能够继续生存。
They will need to look for a way for their own survival.
所以他们离开了自己的职分，离开了自己的本位。
So they left their posts and their duties.
在你我今天来看。
Between you and me today,
这是情有可原的事情嘛。
This is only reasonable.
人家又不是故意的。
This is not intentional.
谁叫以色列人没有拿东西来。
It's because of these Israelites who didn't come to offer.
利未人总是要活下去啊。
The Levites need to live on continually.
所以离开岗位有理。
So it is only reasonable for them to leave their post.
放弃工作好像是必须的。
It's only a necessity for them to leave their jobs.
你可以理解。
You can understand.
你也愿意包容。
You can also endure this.
但是我们如果从这一段圣经的记载来看。
But from the narrative of this passage.
不管你用什么样的理由或者是原因。
Whatever reason that you can come up with.
都不能否认掉，否定掉你放弃了神所赐给你的尊荣。
You cannot deny the fact and the glory that God has given to you.
你说你没有办法。
You said you have no means.
你说你必须生存。
You say you need to survive.
你有理由，你有借口。
You have excuses and reasons.
但是当你回头一看。
But once you turn back and see.
为什么人家撒都的子孙就能够坚持呢？
Why is it that sons of Zadok can continue to maintain themselves?
他们也一样没有了任何的供给啊。
In the same way, they do not have the providence.
所以他们也有生活上的需要。
They also need their daily necessities.
但是撒都的子孙没有离开。
But the sons of Zadok did not depart.
他们有没有饿死？
were they hungered?
没有啊，神继续供养他们。
No, God continued to provide for them.
使他们能够在这一段的时间坚持到底。
So that they can endure to the end throughout this whole period.
所以在这里告诉我们一件事情啊。
Here it tells us one thing.
他说啊，今天的人生，很多时候我们为自己找了很多的理由跟借口。
Throughout this lifetime, many times we find excuses and reasons for ourselves.
你不断地告诉自己。
You tell yourself continually.
这就是 reality, 这就是现实。
This is the reality.
现实就是守道很困难。
The reality is that it's very difficult to hold fast to the truth.
现实就是行道有问题。
The reality is that it's very hard to execute our faith.
现实就是聚会有压力。
The reality is that we are so pressured to come for services.
现实就是奉献很痛苦。
The reality is that it is very painful for us to offer.
很多时候我们可以给自己找了很多的原因、理由，很多不一样的借口。
Many a times we can look and seek for many excuses and reasons in all forms.
然后再不断地告诉自己，告诉自己说，神明白，神了解，神会体谅。
Many a times we tell ourselves, God will understand, He will forbear, He will be sympathetic.
到最后啊，不知道是要欺骗别人，还是要欺骗自己的心啊。
In the end, we don't know if we're deceiving others or deceiving our own hearts.
所以到最后，在软弱当中，觉得自己是合理的。
And in the end, in our weaknesses, we feel that we are it's only reasonable for us to feel this way.
但是当我们看回到这一个在这里的这一个例子。
But when we come back to this example stated here,
利未人所面对的撒都子孙都要面对。
All the things that the priests were to meet with, the sons of Zadok also met with them.
利未人挣扎的撒都子孙一样要挣扎。
The sons of Zadok felt the same struggles as the other Levites.
但是差别在哪里？
But what is the difference?
差别在于撒都的子孙非常清楚自己所侍奉的是谁。
The sons of Zadok are very clear who they are worshipping.
如果你所侍奉的是造天地万物的主宰。
If you are serving today the creator of the heavens and the earth.
难道他今天没有办法供给你所需要的生活上的的需要吗？
Today, is he not able to provide all your daily necessities?
如果你真的相信他是天地万物全能的神，造天地万物全能的神。
If you truly believe that he is the Lord of the heavens and earth and is the creator.
你怎么会害怕说你下一顿饭没有的吃，没有人能够养育你呢？
How can you worry that you don't have your next meal or nobody is providing for you?
所以很多时候只是给我们自己留下很多的借口跟理由而已。
Many a times we only leave for ourselves some excuses and reasons.
其实是缺乏对神完全的信心。
Actually, we are lacking in our complete faith to God.
所以在这里我们看到这撒都的子孙为什么可以亲近神。
But here we can see why is it that sons of Zadok are able to come near to God?
因为在患难当中。
Because in their tribulation,
因为在困难里面。
In their difficulties,
因为在走投无路的困境。
In their dead ends,
却没有任何一件事可以让他们放弃自己的职分跟放弃自己的信仰。
There's not a single thing that can make them depart from their faith and give up their duties.
或许在这个过程当中非常痛苦。
Perhaps throughout this process it's very painful.
他们也不知道还要坚持多久。
They don't know how long they have to endure.
但是在这里说他们坚守了神的圣所。
But here it tells us they kept charge of God's sanctuary.
所以到最后神就为他们开路。
In the end, God opened a way for them.
说时候要到。
The time will come.
这光明要再次照入你黑暗的生命里面。
The light will come once again to shine upon the darkness of your life.
神要在绝境当中为你开路。
In your hopelessness, God will once again open a way.
使你到最后能够看到原来这是神更美的旨意。
So that in the end you will see that this is a much more beautiful plan of God.
能够得到恩典，能够得到奖赏。
You can receive grace and reward.
但是在这恩典跟奖赏之中有一个要求。
But through this grace and reward, there is one prerequisite.
就是你必须要坚守神的圣所啊。
Which is that you have to keep charge of God's sanctuary.
如果你已经离开了。
If you have departed.
压力当中放弃，在困难当中离开。
In your stress or difficulties, you have departed.
不管你怎么解释，不管你找什么样的理由。
No matter how you explain it or with what excuse can you come up with.
都结果就是你离开了。
The result is that you have left.
所以在这里提醒我们今天侍奉得恩典的第一个要求。
Therefore, here it tells us the first prerequisite for us to receive the reward of our servitude.
就是在侍奉当中要忠心，要坚持到底。
That in our servitude we have to be faithful and endure to the end.
我们看回来以西结书的第44章。
Let's refer back to Ezekiel chapter 44.
以西结书的44章。
Ezekiel chapter 44.
16节。
Verse 16.
16节。 他们必进入我的圣所，就近我的桌前侍奉我，守我所吩咐的。十七节，他们进内院门必穿细麻衣，在内院门和殿内供职的时候不可穿羊毛衣服。十八节，他们要头上啊，他们头上要戴细麻布裹头巾，腰穿细麻布裤子，不可使不可穿使身体出汗的衣服。十九节，他们出到外院的民那里，当脱下供职的衣服放在圣屋内，穿上别的衣服，免得因圣衣使民成圣。在这里讲到这撒都子孙的侍奉。
Here it tells us the servitude of the sons of Zadok.
我们刚刚讲到说撒都子孙在神眼中是非常不一样的。
Just now we have mentioned that the sons of Zadok were very distinguished before God.
他们不只是能够侍奉神。
Not only that they can serve God.
同时他们更能够亲近神。
They can also come near to God.
所以作为我们今天侍奉学习的榜样。
They have served as a very good example for our servitude today.
这里告诉我们说，当他们进到神的殿宇。
Here it tells us when they enter into the chamber of God.
他们要穿细麻布的衣服。裤子还有裹头巾啊
！You have to put on linen garments, pants, turbans.
这里特别讲说不可以穿羊毛做的衣服。
And they shall not wear upon them wool.
你会觉得很奇怪，说为什么圣经神还要这样特别吩咐
？You will feel amazed. Why does the Bible need to explain why God is instructing all these?
还要特别讲说要穿细麻布。
And also specifically mention about linen.
不可以穿羊毛。
You cannot wear wool.
其实关键在最后面这一句话。
Actually, the great emphasis should be at the latter portion.
他说不要穿使身体出汗的衣服啊。
You cannot wear something that make you sweat.
所以在这里告诉我们。
Here it tells us.
说神的工人来到神的圣殿。
When the workers of God come into the holy sanctuary.
当我们来亲近神侍奉神。
When we're coming near to God and ministering to God.
在侍奉当中不可以流汗啊
！In our servitude, we cannot sweat.
你会突然抓抓头，哇，不能流汗，怎么有办法不流汗呢
？You will scratch your head and think, why can I sweat?
流汗是人身体的反应。
To perspire is only a bodily response.
你太热的时候自然会流汗。
When you feel it's too hot, you will naturally perspire.
你太紧张的时候自然就会流汗。
When you feel very stressed, you will naturally perspire.
所以这个是人的自然身体反应。
This is a naturally bodily response.
那为什么神在这里要特别交代这些工人？
Then why is it that God have to make special instructions to
the workers? 所侍奉当中不要穿使身体出汗的衣服啊。
That you shall not clothe yourself with anything that causes sweat.
我们来看创世纪的第三章。
Let's refer to Genesis chapter 3.
创世纪的第三章。
The book of Genesis chapter 3.
创世纪三章的第十九节。
Genesis chapter 3 verse 19.
十九节，你必汗流满面才得糊口，直到你归了土，因为你是从土而出的。你本是尘土，人要归于尘土。这里是圣经当中对流汗的第一个记载。
Here is the first recording of sweat.
当亚当跟夏娃犯罪得罪了神。
When Adam and Eve has offended God by sinning.
他们被赶出了伊甸园。
They were taken away from the Garden of Eden.
从原本生活当中无忧无虑，神供给所有。
From a worryless life, where God provides for everything.
再到被赶出之后，就要自己想办法努力的生存下去。
To the point of time where they were taken out of the Garden of Eden, and they have to do their best for their own survival.
所以在这里，神对亚当说啊。
Over here, God spoke to Adam.
他说你要汗流满面才能够糊口啊。
In the sweat of your face, you shall eat bread.
所以汗流满面流汗是人的努力跟付出。
To perspire and have sweat refers to one's great effort.
靠着人的劳力来养活自己。
Relying upon one's labor. to sustain themselves.
但是我们如果用这一段来看回以西结书的44章，
But when we refer back to Ezekiel chapter 44,
那告诉我们说，祭司你今天侍奉，不要穿使身体流汗的衣服。
That the priest shall not wear clothing that will make themselves sweat.
这是要给你我今天在侍奉的工作上做一个提醒。
This serves as a reminder for us in our servitude today.
今天工作要努力。
Today we have to put in efforts in our work.
但是侍奉不是靠你自己流汗而得的。
But your servitude does not, it's not based on your own sweat.
流汗是人的付出，流汗是人的能力。
Sweating is the ability of mankind.
靠着我的努力，教会今天发展。
According to my own efforts, the church is prospering.
因为有我的坚持，今天圣工才会兴旺。
Because of my endurance today,
你看我做的多辛苦。
You see how laborsome I am.
你看我流的满身汗。
You see I'm sweating throughout myself.
你看教会没有我要怎么办呢？
How can the church survive without me?
这个就是人的流汗啊。
This is the sweat of man.
但是在这里神却告诉我们。
But here God tells us.
今天在教会的侍奉当中是不应该流汗的。
Our servitude in the church, we shall not sweat.
为什么不应该流汗？
Why can't we sweat?
因为我们人只是尽力尽本分而已。
Because we're only fulfilling our basic duties as mankind.
一件圣工会不会有成就？
How can a sacred work come to fruition?
到最后会发生什么样的事？
In the end, what things will happen?
不在你的手中，也不在我的手中。
It is not in the grasp of your hand or mine.
因为这是神的工作。
Because this is the work of God.
所以在哥林多前书，保罗告诉我们。
Therefore, Paul states in 1 Corinthians.
他说，我们只是与神同工的。
We are only working together with God.
这个工作不是你的。
This work is not yours.
有时候我们太过于努力了。
Sometimes we put in too much effort.
到最后我们把这个工作揽在手上，这就是我的工作啊。
In the end, we are grabbing on to all the work and saying that this is my job.
用人的方法，用人的努力，用人的流汗，想要来完成神的侍奉。
You use the method of man, the sweat of man, and your own efforts to accomplish God's work.
有一次在一间教会。
One time in one church,
这是他们在灵恩会的时候啊。
During a particular spiritual convocation,
有一个姐妹啊，带了一个慕道朋友来到教会。
A sister brought a truth-seeking friend to the church.
这个年头啊，带慕道者越来越困难哦。
These years, it is very hard to bring a truth-seeker to come to church.
大家呀，有时候大部分很多人对信仰都没有什么兴趣。
Because many a times, many people do not have any interest to faith.
所以呀，要带一个慕道者来不容易啊。
So it's not easy to bring a truth-seeking friend.
所以这个姐妹啊，哇，辛苦的带了一个慕道朋友来到了教会。
So this sister, with a lot of effort, brought this friend to the church.
来到教会以后啊，这个姐妹说啊，我去一下洗手间，你在这里等我一下。
In the church, this sister went to the bathroom and then instructed the friend, saying, "Please wait here."
她就先去厕所了。
So she retreated to the restroom.
这个时候啊，教会有其他的人看到，这个不认识啊，这个没有见过。
And then at this time, there are many other people who saw that we have never seen this friend before.
所以啊，就有几个姐妹也上来呀、啊，跟她寒暄，跟她问候啊。
So some sisters came up and engage in a conversation with this friend.
这个时候啊，这个姐妹啊，从厕所回来了。
At this time, this sister came back from the restroom.
一看啊，不得了了，马上跑过来啊。
When she saw this scene, it's not good. She ran over here.
把这个慕道朋友一抓啊。
She quickly took this friend by her side.
我说这个是我的，你们自己去找自己的啊。
This is my friend. You look for your own friends.
有时候就是这样啊。
Sometimes it's this way.
慕道朋友变成是我的
A true-seeking friend is mine.
教会圣工变成是我的
The sacred work in the church is mine.
所以到最后啊，常常就是流得满身汗啊。
So many a times we fill ourselves with sweat.
不是说今天侍奉不要努力。
It's not that we do not pay effort into our servitude.
而是在侍奉当中不要把仁义丢进去啊。
But in our servitude, let us not put in our human will.
我的坚持。
My persistence.
我的奋斗。
My
我的意志力一定要达到这个工作啊。
My effort and my ideologies have to be accomplished.
我的决心啊。Determination.
My determination.
到最后，这些都是啊，让你流的满身大汗。
In the end, this will cause a lot of sweat throughout your body.
但是在侍奉当中却不能够得到神的喜悦。
But in your servitude, you fail to gain favor in the sight of God.
所以我们今天要怎么做？
But today, what do we do?
这里告诉我们说啊，穿那个不会流汗的衣服啊。
Here tells us wear your garments that will not cause sweat.
用心侍奉。
You will use your heart to serve.
善尽本分。
You will use all your talents.
为主努力。
You put in all efforts.
但是到最后学会交托啊。
But in the end, you need to learn how to entrust everything.
你如果真的把它交出去了。
If you entrust them to God,
都在神的手中。
It is all in the hands of God.
我在神面前良心平安。
Before God, my conscience is clear.
我尽力了。
I have done my part.
剩下的部分求主帮助。
The rest of the way, may God lead us.
那你为什么要流汗？
Then why do you need to sweat?
为什么晚上睡不着？
Why can't you sleep at night?
为什么整天紧张兮兮？
Why are you so stressful throughout the day?
不是在神的手中吗？
Isn't all this in the hands of God?
所以这是第二个给你我今天做一个思考跟学习的。
This is the second factor for example for you and me.
人侍奉神要用心。
For us who serve God, we have to use our hearts.
但是不要只用自己的力呀。
But don't use your personal agendas.
所以保罗讲得很清楚哦。
Paul said very clearly.
保罗说，我什么时候软弱，我就刚强了。
Whenever I'm weak, I'm strong.
什么时候我知道我在神面前能做得很有限。
Whenever I realize that I'm only limited before God,
那我就交托给那全能的主宰。
At that time, I will entrust to the Lord of hosts.
既然交托给神啊，
since I've entrusted him to his care,
没有压力，自然轻松，就不流汗啊。
I don't have any burdens or stress. Naturally, I do not need to sweat.
所以这是给你我今天侍奉的一个提醒。
So this serves as a reminder for you and me today.
当我们看回来以西结书的44章，
let's refer back to Ezekiel chapter 44,
第十八节，
verse 18.
十八节，他们头上要戴细麻布裹头巾，腰穿细麻布裤子，不可穿使身体出汗的衣服。十九节，他们出到外院的民那里，当脱下供职的衣服，放在圣屋内，穿上别的衣服，免得因圣衣使民成圣啊！这里又继续讲到他们所穿的衣服。
Here it continues to provide instructions upon their clothing.
所以神对这侍奉的祭司穿着打扮有直接的要求啊。
God has strict regulations to the priest and the Levite to serve.
神说你要穿这些衣服。
God said you have to wear these garments,
使你不会流汗，
so that you will not have sweat.
啊，但是在这里又特别强调哦。
But here it's emphasized again.
他说，当你离开圣所的时候，
once you have departed from the holy chambers,
当你要离开，你要到外面去啊。
When you are going outside,
这里说，请你把供职的衣服把它脱掉。
Please take off your holy garments.
他说，你把这个衣服留在圣屋内。
You please leave them in the holy chambers.
然后穿上别的衣服，你才可以离开呀。
Then put on other garments. Only then can you depart.
这也是给你我今天在侍奉的路上的一个提醒。
This also serves as a reminder for us in our journey of servitude.
他说这个衣服是神所给予的。
These garments are given by God.
是用来侍奉的。
It is meant for service.
所以这个衣服虽然是你穿在身上。
Even though this garment is worn upon you.
但是这一件衣服不是你的。
But this garment is not yours.
他说，当你要离开圣所的时候，
when you are departing from the holy chambers,
你要把这个衣服留在神的圣所当中。
You have to leave these holy garments.
免得因这些圣衣使百姓成圣啊。
Lest it will sanctify the people.
这里到底要提醒你我什么事情？
What is our reminder through this?
说这个圣衣是神所给祭司穿戴的衣服。
These holy garments are imparted upon the priests.
啊，代表的是神所赋予的荣耀。
This represents the fullness of God's glory.
代表的是神所赋予的权柄。
Represents the authority that God gave them.
所以当我们在侍奉工作当中，
so in our servitude,
因为教会工作的需要，
because of the need and the holy work,
有时候我们会有一些工作上的名称，
sometimes we hold special titles,
或者是有一些职分上的给予，
or some job titles.
所以啊，这个是神所赋予在我们身上的责任、权柄、荣耀。
These are the three things that is imparted upon us: the glory, the duty, and the responsibility.
但是虽然放在你身上，让你穿了。
Even though these garments are put upon us,
这里告诉我们说啊，你不要以为这件衣服是你的啊。
Here it tells us, don't think that these garments belong to you.
这个荣耀不是你的，是神先暂时放在你身上。
This glory is not yours alone. These are temporary glory.Placed upon you.
这个权柄不是你的，是神暂时让你使用。
This authority is not yours. This is authority given by God to you temporarily.
千万不要在侍奉当中最后忘记自己是谁。
Let us not in our servitude finally forget who we are.
以为说这件圣衣就是我的。
Thinking that these holy garments are ours.
以为这个权柄就由我掌握。
Thinking that we have all full authority.
以为教会里面我说了算，因为我最大。
Saying that in the church I am the biggest, therefore I have the most say.
这里告诉我们说，当你要离开的时候，把圣衣脱掉，放在神的圣所。
Here instructs us that when we are about to depart, we have to take off the holy garments, put them in the holy chambers.
因为荣耀不是你的啊。
Because the glory is not yours.
啊，所以我们今天在侍奉神的路上。
So in our journey of servitude.
千万不要到最后搞错了，穿着这个神的圣衣到处乱跑。
Let us not make a big mistake by running around wearing the holy garments.
生怕别人没有看到你这一身金光闪闪，
being so afraid that we are wearing this so glorious and so bright of a garment，
跑到哪里都跟人家说，你知道我是谁吗？
Wherever we go, we ask people, do you know who I am?
你知道我做过什么圣工吗？
Do you know what sacred work I have accomplished?
你知道我在教会是什么职分吗？
Do you know what job do I carry in the church?
你知道教会里面啊，我脚踏一踏地要震三下啊。
Do you know that once I stomp my feet, there will be an earthquake?
能够再更幼稚一点吗？
Can you be so more immature?
哦，真的，这在真的这这个这在这看起来这真的是一种非常无知而且幼稚的行为啊。
This is such an ignorant and immature behavior.
把神的圣衣从圣所当中拿出来。
To bring the holy garments of God, from the holy chambers.
违背了神的旨意，还自己沾沾自喜。
We're going against God's will and still, gleaming in joy.
夸耀那不是你的荣耀，还自以为了不起。
We are being proud of the glory that does not even belong to us.
等到最后神动手责备，你就来不及。
Wait until when God strike with His own hand, then we don't have enough time.
所以今天就是给你我的一个提醒啊。
So this serves as a reminder for you and me.
说当我们要离开圣所，把圣衣留在里面，那是神的。
When we are departing from the holy chambers, we have to leave the holy garments.
哦，后面这里又特别告诉我们啊。
Because they belong to God, and here in the end, it tells us.
他说啊，你不要把圣衣穿出去。
That do not put on your holy garments.
免得因圣衣使民成圣啊。
Lest you sanctify the people.
这一句话我们看了也是觉得有点奇怪啊。
When we see this, it sounds weird.
让民成圣有什么不好？
What is wrong with sanctifying the people?
让民成圣难道不对吗？
It is wrong. Is it wrong to sanctify the people?
这里的问题在哪里？
Where is the problem here?
这件圣衣是神的。
This holy garment belongs to God.
荣耀归于神，权柄归于神。
The glory and authority, power belongs to God.
当你把这个圣衣带出去，拿去彰显的时候，
when we display these holy garments to other people,
你给谁看？
Who are you displaying it to? Who are you displaying it to?
你影响到的第一个是谁？
Who are in your sphere of influence?
你影响到的第一个一定是你的家人啊。
It must be your family.
哦，你的太太、你的先生、你的儿女、你的家人啊，这是第一群被影响的人。
The first group of people who are being influenced is your wife, your husband, and your kids.
哦，所以在这里啊，神特别警告我们啊。
So here, God specifically warns us.
不但你不能把圣衣穿出去。
Not only that you cannot wear the holy garments out,
更不能让这个圣衣拿来给你的家人做这个彰扬的一个工具啊。
You cannot boast for your holy garments to your family.
哦，所以我们在神学院的时候，老师有特别告诉我们。
Therefore, in the TTP, the teachers tell us.
他说啊，说神所安立的是你。
God anointed you.
不是你的太太，不是你的儿女。
Not your wife or your kids.
所以信徒所尊重的是神的工人。
So the people in the church, the believers will respect the worker of God.
啊，当然，因为爱神，所以信徒爱工人。
Of course, due to their love to God, they love the worker.
而常常因为爱工人，所以对工人的家人多一份的爱护，多一份的尊重。
And due to their love to the worker, they also love and respect the workers' family members.
哦，这个作为教会的工人，我们要在这里要感谢大家的照顾跟爱护啊。
As workers of the church, we need to give thanks to the members of the church for your love and care.
但是同时，我们要特别提醒，特别谨慎小心。
At the same time, we have to be very careful and be very warned.
千万不要因为这个职分使我们的家人忘记了自己是谁。
Let us not because of this duty, we will forget ourselves.
穿上圣衣在外面招摇。
We boast and display to others our holy garments.
哦，好像说，因为我是谁的谁，我就特别不一样啊。
Because I am who and who, I am extremely different.
哦，这个是我们要特别谨慎的。
We are very careful in this.
更要常常观察，并且提醒自己的家人。
We have to constantly observe ourselves and remind our family members.
能侍奉是个恩典。
To be able to serve, it is a grace from God.
信徒尊重我们，是因为看在神的面子上面。
The members respect us.Because of God.
我们自己本身没有什么可夸口的。
We ourselves don't have anything to boast about.
所以虽然信徒尊重传道跟传道的家人。
Because the members, respect the workers and the workers' family.
但是我们自己要有更高的要求。
Because we ourselves have to have a higher standard.
要更加的谦卑。
We have to be more humble.
因为在这里神说得非常清楚啊。
Because here God says specifically.
我说这个圣衣不是让你拿出去让你的家人成圣的。
Because these holy garments are not to be displayed and sanctify your family.
所以我们如果没有听神的警告，
If we don't heed to God's warnings,
把神的荣耀挂在自己身上，
We hang upon ourselves God's glory.
滥用神所赐予的权柄来为家人，来赋予在家人的身上，
And abuse the authority given to us by God on our family members.
所以到最后工人要受更重的审判啊。
In the end, the worker will have a greater punishment.
就像我们在撒母耳记上所看到这个以利的儿子一样。
Just as it's written in 1 Samuel, the sons of Eli.
以利是老先知。
Eli was an old prophet.
老祭司。
Or old priest.
在神的殿中服侍多年。
In the temple of God, he has served many years.
但是因为他的关系啊。
However, because of his relations.
他的儿子在神的殿中啊，任意妄行。
His sons did everything according to their own eyes.
甚至百姓都拿他们没有办法。
Even the people cannot do anything about it.
为什么？因为披着以利的圣衣乱跑啊。
Why? Because they put on the holy garments given by Eli.
以利没有处理。
Eli did not take care of the matter.
以利啊，也没有讲，也没有骂，也没有处理他的孩子。
Eli did not take measures to resolve this problem.
你不处理没关系，神帮你处理啊。
You did not resolve the problem. That's okay. God will resolve it for you.
到最后的后果跟下场不是你我想要看见跟承担的。
The end result is not something that you and I want to see.
这不是只有在传道者的身上啊。
This is not done only upon the ministers.
是在每一个参与教会圣工的工人的身上。
This applies to every worker of the sacred work.
神所赐赋予你的圣衣。
The holy garments put upon you by God.
这尊荣的外袍。
This glorious outer garment.
是属于圣所留在神家的。
It belongs in the holy chambers and should be left there.
当我们能够常常这样提醒自己。
When we can constantly remind ourselves about
this. 也能够这样常常提醒自己的家人。
And we can constantly remind our family members.
使我们在侍奉的路上能够更加的谦卑。
So that on our road to servitude, we can be more and more humble.
到最后神就要在最后的审判当中将你高举。
In the end, the day of judgment, God will uplift you.
当你放下了这个神的圣所的荣耀。
When you put aside all this glory of the holy sanctuary.
神在最后就要赋予你永恒的光荣。
In the end, God will put upon you the eternal glory.
这是一个选择。
This is an option.
你可以选择现在抢夺神的荣耀。
However, you can have the option to steal God's glory today.
然后面对神的愤怒。
And then face the wrath of God.
或者是按照神的吩咐。
Or you heed the instructions of God.
留下神的圣衣。
Put away the holy garments.
穿上普通的衣服。
Put an ordinary garment upon yourself.
进入百姓之中。
Enter into the people.
到最后大得天上赏赐。
In the end, you receive a big reward.
我们一起来唱诗。
Let us sing him.
一起唱诗198首。
Let us sing him number 198.
请坐。
Please be seated.
感谢主，我们要来做聚会结束的祷告。
Thank God, we are now going to offer our final prayer after service.
早上我们花了一点时间来看一看这个撒都的子孙。
In the morning, we have spent some time to see the sons of Zadok.
撒都的子孙跟其他的利未人其实没有什么两样。
Actually, the sons of Zadok are not any different from the other Levites.
他们没有食物，也会饥饿。
They will also hunger without food.
他们看不到以后，他们看不到盼望，也会害怕。
They will be afraid without seeing hope.
他们也不知道说到底什么时候以色列人才会回来。
They also do not know when will the Israelites come back.
甚至他们不知道自己下一餐到底在哪里。
They also are unaware where is their next meal.
所以这些撒都的子孙他们会害怕。
So these sons of Zadok are may be fearful.
面对压力他们也会迷惑。
They may be confused when facing stress.
看不到将来的盼望他们也会为自己的家人来紧张。
Without seeing the future hope, they are also stressful for their families.
所以他跟你我其实没有什么两样的。
Actually, they are not any different from you and me.
但是在这里有一个非常不同的地方。
However, there is a distinguishing point here.
就是虽然恐惧，但是从不放弃。
Even though they are fearful, they have never given up.
虽然有压力，但是总能够坚持。
Among their stress, they are able to endure.
虽然不知道神什么时候会帮助，但是从不放手。
Even though they don't know when God is going to provide help, they have never let go.
所以到最后，他们就能够看见神怎么为他们开了天上的窗户。
So in the end, they are able to see how God opened the windows of heaven.
所以信仰的路，恐惧从来不是问题。
On the journey of faith, fear is not a factor.
面对压力，害怕也没有关系。
Fear facing stress is also not a problem.
但是在患难跟压力、恐惧跟困难之下。
But in the trials and tribulations, the fear and the difficulties.
你怎么做决定？
What is your decision?
当这撒都的子孙咬着牙继续往前走，
When these sons of Zadok persisted in their journey,
就决定了他们能够终身亲近神、侍奉神的结果。
They have determined their destiny in a lifetime, which is are able to come near God and serve God.
你的生命当中或许有患难，或许有困难。
In your lifetime, you may have difficulties and tribulations.
你不是唯一的一个。
You're not the only one experiencing this.
很多弟兄姐妹，大家都要面对生活上的困难。
Many brothers and sisters are experiencing the same difficulties as you.
都在面对信仰上的压力。
They are facing the stress of the faith.
但是这一条路你要怎么走下去？
But how are you to walk on this journey.
愿主耶稣能够帮助我们每一个人。
May the Lord Jesus guide us.
借着圣灵给予你我勇敢坚持的力量。
Through the Holy Spirit, give us the strength.
眼泪擦擦。
To wipe away our tears.
咬咬牙。
And to bite our teeth.
勇敢继续往下走。
To have the courage to continue to walk on.
因为你的神从来不会让你失望。
Because your God will never disappoint you.
一起来祷告。
Let us pray.